This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In the Dungeons. 7 Bodak, 8 Boneclaw, 81 Miniatures, 9 Brain in a Jar, 10 Corpse Gatherer, 11 Crimson Death, 12 Death Knight, 13 Devourer, 14 Dracolich, 15 Effigy, 16 Flameskull, 17 Ghost, 18 Ghoul, 19 Lich, 20 More, 21 Mummy, 22 Nightshade, 23 Shadow, 24 Skeleton, 25 Skeleton Warrior, 26 Spectre, 27 Vampire, 28 White, 29 Raxbon, 30 Wraith, 31 Zombie, 32 Other Undead, 321 Other Undead from the 3rd Edition Monster Manual, 2 322 Other Undead from the V35 Monster Manual, 3 323 Other Undead from the V35 Monster Manual, IV 324 Other Undead from the V35 Monster Manual, V325 Other Undead from the 3rd Edition Fiend Folio, 33 see also, 34 notes, 35 references. Publication history. Advanced Dungeons. This section is empty. You can help by adding to it. March 2015 Allip main article. Allip. The Allip is an undead creature, the spectral remains of someone driven to suicide by madness in life. They are found on any land and underground. They are solitary and carry nothing with them, despite having the intellect of a human. In the 3rd edition Monster Manual, an Allip is described as having the same features that it did in life, but greatly distorted. The mouth is twisted, and the eyes glow from the waist down. It becomes much more gas-like, looking like a typical ghost. It has no legs, and trails off into vaporous nothingness. It leaves a faint trail of fog behind it as it moves. Animus characteristics. Alignment. Any evil type undead. Image stats. Publication history. Source books. From the Ashes, Ivid the Undying. First appearance from the Ashes in the World of Greyhawk. Campaign setting for Dungeons. Dead, no disease can be fatal or terminal to an animus. The animuses are a legacy of the alliance between the House of Naelix and the Devil Balzephon in the 440s Psi. An ancestor to the Naelix line of Overkings made contact with Balzephon to further his own powerbase. Balzephon promised to aid the Naelix in gaining the position of Overking in exchange for the souls of the Naelix line. Part of this aid rendered would be the secrets to making animuses around 583 Psi. During the Greyhawk Wars, the first animuses were created. Overking David V, paranoid about disloyal advisors and nobles, had numerous key generals, nobles and lords assassinated, particularly after the defeat of Erdi forces at the Battle of Inspa. Their bodies were handed over to priests of Hexter and pit fiends supplied by Balzephon. Each body was imbued with an admixture of divine and fiendish arcane spells, while the souls resided in an artifact on loan from Balzephon. The casket of abyssal bone amongst those transformed into animuses was, eventually, Ivid himself, transformed on the orders of Balzephon, who hoped to stave off the wasting disease that had afflicted Ivid and threatened to kill him. The aim was to keep Ivid as a stable puppet on the Malachite throne. The plan failed, however, as the disease progressed unchecked since the loss of Roxas and with it Ivid. There have been no means to create new animuses, as Balzephon's devils and the casket have vanished along with the capital of the Great Kingdom. The exact spells used to create animuses have also been lost as well. However, numerous animuses still walk the lands of the Erdi since Ivid's disappearance. The magical effects that bound them to loyalty to him were diminished, and many of the animuses pursue their own plans. A second story places the blame of the creation of the animuses, at least initially, on Lady Lorana Cath, one of the 12 Death Knights created by Demogorgon. In this telling, she created the first anime from peasantry from her fiefdom near Stringen, either as a means of finding a lover who could tolerate being near a death knight, or in the hopes of finding a way of undoing the transformation imposed upon her by Demogorgon. She later revealed the secret of animus creation to Ivid V and the priesthood of Hexter as a means of currying favor. Under this theory, Cath is thought to be still capable of creating new animuses, a potential that she uses as a means of retaining power within the priesthood of Hexter. Publishing history. The animus first appeared in From the Ashes, which linked the first appearance of the monster to the Greyhawk Wars storyline. The idea was fleshed out in the never released but available online supplement Ivid the Undying. The monster was later updated in 2001 for 3rd edition in the Living Greyhawk Journal, and for 35 in Dragon Magazine's Creature Catalog feature. There have been no official game stats allowing players to replicate the process of creating animuses, and it is explicitly said that the process would be impossible to replicate in game statistics known animuses. Prince Angzandarian of Distrith Delglath of Rinloru, who can secrete acid from his palms. Drax the Invulnerable, ruler of Rel Astra. Prince Hastern Overking Ivid V. Prince Gkryson Jareen. Prince Kalord General Kalrith. Prince Kobason. Count Madril Ishenvan of Paralad. Marin of Errantkeep. Duke Zephron of Almor, said to have been given iron-like skin during his transformation. Prince Zamaskin. Ashen Husk. Main article, Ashen Husk. The Ashen Husk is an undead formed from the animated corpses of those who died of thirst and dehydration while in the desert. Contrary to being labeled as animated corpses, however, they are not zombies. Baelnorn. Baelnorn characteristics. Alignment. Lawful good. Mainly type undead. A Baelnorn is a fictional undead creature, usually a spellcaster. They are described as elves who sought undeath to serve their families, communities, or other purposes, usually to see a wrong righted or to achieve a certain magic discovery or deed. They are lich-like creatures that appear as impressive-looking elves with shriveled skin and glowing white eyes. Most of their appearances in modules, setting books, games, novels and the like are related to the Old Lords of Cormanthur, Myth Draenor, a fictional location in the Forgotten Realms campaign setting. Baelnorns are created through a powerful arcane or divine necromantic ritual, typically, elven characters choosing to pursue a duty which would extend beyond death voluntarily go through the process. The process is described as similar to that of a lich, but does not result in the fear-oriented abilities attributed to liches. The ritual permits the character to retain all of its memories, personality, and abilities. In addition, the process alters a character's abilities, conferring many of the powers seen in other types of undead monsters, including paralyzing touches and summoning other, lesser forms of undead. In the Forgotten Realms setting, gold or sun elves are the most likely to pursue this goal, but first must find the approval of various groups, sometimes including the Seldarine, to become a Baelnorn instead of a lich. A character must be of a non-evil alignment, usually lawful good. However, a Baelnorn may become evil after the ritual, as seen in the character Tordner Ravern, detailed in the supplement Lords of Dark Darkness in D&D. Is kidnapped by a cult. The Forgotten Realms novels The Siege and The Lost Library of Cormanthyr both include Guardian Baelnorn characters. The character Tordner Ravern is detailed in the supplement Lords of Darkness as a Baelnorn archmage who has become evil and shows hatred for humans. Bloodhulk. Bloodhulk characteristics. Alignment. Neutral. Evil type undead. Publication history. Source books. Monster Manual. IV. The Bloodhulk is an undead being that was originally an evil, fanatical, shamanistic human or similar creature whom others had come to worship as a god, and had too many sacrifices made to them. When it dies, the gallons of blood from those sacrificed to the Bloodhulk begins to run in its veins, and it arises as oozing, hulking, misshapen abomination. Bloodhulks resemble humans, albeit very vaguely. So full of blood have their muscles, skin, sinews and such become that they look nothing short of mutated, and their identity is completely lost. Their veins bulge through their thick, red, rippling skin, struggling to pump blood to their gargantuan upper mass. Their heads are incredibly disproportionate to the rest of their body, being shriveled and wizened and tiny at the top of their massive torsos. Original research. Under second edition rules, Bloodhulks are described as incredibly bestial creatures with no desire other than to roam around and obtain the blood of any who would encroach upon what was their territory. In life, for each victim the Bloodhulk kills with their brute strength and powerful fists, they consume the remains and become stronger from the blood. Eventually their hearts can no longer take the strain, however, and the creatures shrivel and die for some reason. Bloodhulks are often depicted with other, smaller Bloodhulks, possibly clerics or such, which had also received a small portion of the blood from the Bloodhulk sacrifices in life. As of 3rd edition, Bloodhulks seem to have lost their clerical background, their blood-consuming ability, and their vulnerability to cardiac failure. They are essentially on par with zombies, although with increased size and hit points and a vulnerability to piercing weapons. Most Bloodhulks cannot speak. The few that can speak speak Undercommon. The Bloodhulk Crusher, Bloodhulk Fighter, and Bloodhulk Giant appeared in the Monster Manual IV 2006. Bodak. Bodak characteristics. Alignment. Chaotic. Evil type undead. Image. Wizards.com. Image stats. Open game license stats. The Bodak is an undead creature in the dungeons. Return as Bodaks. The Bodak was introduced to the D&D. And half without skin, with their sinew and muscle exposed. The most prominent feature of the Boneclaw are its claws. Its three, bony fingernails seem to grow and shrink randomly between 2 and 10 feet long, and are razor sharp. They are constructed using a secret magical ritual to hunt and kill living creatures, whether to sadistically end the lives of the innocent, or due to being in the service of a necromancer or such who commands them to do so. The purpose of Boneclaws in the dungeons. was a rare miniatures in the Deathknell expansion. The second, also a rare, was the Boneclaw Impaler in the Against the Giants expansion. Brain in a Jar for the Thought Experiment. See Brain in a Vat. Brain in a Jar. Characteristics: alignment, usually neutral. Evil type, undead. Image, Wizards.com image. Publication history: source books. Libris Mortis. Brain in a Jar is, simply put, an undead brain in a jar of preservative fluid. It was introduced in Libris Mortis, A.D. Abilities. The brain in a jar is a masterpiece of preservation, but where alchemical preservatives leave off, necromancy picks up. An animated brain in a jar is, in truth, an undead creature. Additionally, a brain in a jar possesses potent mental powers. Psionics: merely removing the brain of a zombie or some other undead creature and storing it in alchemical preservatives is not enough to create an undead brain with psionic ability. The ritual of extraction, the spells of formulation, and the alchemical recipes of preservation are closely guarded secrets held by only a few master necromancers. The creation of a brain in a jar is difficult and fraught with danger, because once its mental powers are fully developed, this undead creature is adept at controlling the thoughts and minds of other creatures, especially living creatures. It is not unknown for a brain in a jar to take control over the necromancer who created it. The brain in a jar uses mainly psionic abilities to do what its lack of moving parts would otherwise prevent: move itself, manipulate objects and the environment, and ward off attackers. Its main attack is mind thrust, an assault upon the mind of another creature. In addition to this, it can also drive mad anyone who magically or psionically detects it, and it can control and rebuke other undead. Corpse Gatherer. Characteristics: alignment, usually neutral type, undead. Image, Wizards.com image. Publication history: source books. Monster Manual 2 3rd edition. The Corpse Gatherer is an undead creature that appears as a giant made of earth and stone. Upon closer inspection, one can see headstones, dead hands and heads protruding from its bulk. The monster is essentially an animated graveyard. A Corpse Gatherer can swallow any creature in its grasp. The victim then takes bludgeoning damage from rocks, gravestones, etc. in the creature's body. It can also increase its mass by absorbing corpses. When a Corpse Gatherer is destroyed, it falls apart into its component corpses. The undead's animating force converts these corpses into zombies. Crimson Death. Crimson Death. Characteristics: alignment, neutral. Evil type, undead. Image, Wizards.com image. The Crimson Death is an undead creature in the Dungeons entry. The Crimson Death appeared in the 3rd edition Monster Manual 2 2002. Death Knight. Further information: Death Knight Dungeons image. Wizards.com image. Publication history: source books. Monster Manual 2 3rd edition. The Effigy is an undead hybrid of a ghost or specter and a fire elemental. It is an envious undead creature that hates living creatures and lusts after the life energy they possess. It possesses the bodies of living creatures and takes over their lives, but eventually the possessed body catches fire from the inside from the corruption, turns into a flaming zombie, and is destroyed, and the Effigy must find a new host. An Effigy appears as a ghostly, translucent humanoid shape with a fiendish countenance and composed of burning, multicolored flame. Its eyes glow white within the flickering fires of its insubstantial body, but it has no other discernible facial features. Clawed, fiery arms can also be made out. The Effigy's preferred form of attack is to possess a living body and then use this body to attack a creature infused. Possessed with an Effigy does fire damage, and has an energy draining touch. A wisdom check can be made against an Effigy to drive it out of a host, or to prevent it from entering in the first place. Flameskull main article, Flameskull Ghost. Further information, Ghost Dungeons. Skeleton Warrior. Further information, Skeleton Warrior Dungeons. Wraith. Further information, Wraith Dungeons. Deathshrieker. Drowned. Dust White. Ephemeral Swarm. Grimweird. Necronaut. Plague Spewer. Salt Mummy. Vesuth and Other Undead from the V35 Monster Manual. IV Defacer. Necrosis. Carnex. Plague Walker. Web Mummy. Vitreous Drinker. Other Undead from the V35 Monster Manual. V Blackwing Haunt. Phantom. Sanguineous Drinker. Skull Lord. Spectral Rider. Vampire. Examples: the Black Duke. The Red Widow. Other Undead from the 3rd edition. Fiend Folio. Abyssal Ghoul. Boo. Crawling Head. Crypt Thing. Demon Blood Fiend. Wakuva Template. Hulathoan. Cuth Marin. Symbiont. Ghostly Visage. Swordwraith Template. Ulgerstasta. See also Deathless Dungeons. Carrot. ABC Monster Manual 4th Edition, by Mike Merles, Stephen Schubert, and James Wyatt, copyright 2008. Wizards of the Coast. Carrot. ABC Monster Manual 3, 3rd Edition, copyright 2004. Wizards of the Coast. Carrot. Deathknell Miniatures Gallery at Wizards of the Coast's website. Carrot. Against the Giants Miniatures Gallery at Wizards of the Coast's website. Carrot. Bonnie, Ed, Jeff Grubb, Rich Redman, Skip Williams, and Steve Winter. Monster Manual 2. Wizards of the Coast, 2002. References. Reynolds, Worlds, Sean K. Creature Catalog IV, Campaign Classics, Dragon Number 339, Paizo Publishing, 2006, Turnbull, Don, Ed Fiend Folio TSR, 1981, Cook, Monty Monstrous Compendium, Planescape Compendium 3 TSR, 1998, Stevens, Owen K.C., The Ecology of the Devourer, Dragon Number 355, Paizo Publishing, 2007, Bonnie, Ed, Jeff Grubb, Rich Redman, Skip Williams, Steve Winter Monster Manual 2, Wizards of the Coast, 2002. Reynolds, Sean K. Enchiridion of the Fiend Sage, Living Greyhawk Journal No. 2, Paizo Publishing, 2001, Sergeant, Carl from the Ashes TSR, 1992, Sergeant, Carl Ivid the Undying TSR, unpublished, available online, Gigax, Gary Monster Manual TSR, 1977, Williams, Skip, Jonathan Tweet, and Monty Cook Monster Manual, Wizards of the Coast, 2000, Cormanthier, Empire of the Elves Zip Realms Lore, Safeholds Part 3 Realms Lore, Storm Silverhand's Quieter Days, Part 4 Forgotten Realms Campaign Setting Lost Empires of Faerun Faiths and Pantheons Lost Library of Cormanthier Elminster in Hell Monsters of Faerun Sea Devil's Eye Lords of Darkness. Pool of Radiance VE Dungeons. Dungeon Master Game Mechanics Magic Miniatures Creators Dave Arneson Keith Baker Ed Greenwood Jeff Grubb Gary Gigax Tracy Hickman Robert J. Kuntz Mike Merles Frank Mentzer Jim Ward Margaret Wise Companies Grenadier Models. Hasbro Judges Guild Paizo RAL Partha Strategic Simulations TSR Wizards of the Coast Licenses Game System License Open Game License System Reference Document. Council of Worms Dark Sun Dragonlance Eberron Forgotten Realms Ghostwalk Greyhawk Kara Tur Mystara Planescape Ravenloft Spelljammer Worlds Abair Toril Eberron Kryn Mystara Orth. Underdark Planes of Existence Prime Material Plane Inner Planes Outer Planes Far Realm Plane of Shadow. Half-Orc Human Tiefling Classes Barbarian Bard Cleric Druid Fighter Magic User, Mage, Wizard Monk, Mystic Paladin Ranger Sorcerer Thief, Rogue Warlock List of Alternative Classes Character Lists. Dragonlance Forgotten Realms Greyhawk Ravenloft Notable Characters Drizzt Doerden Elminster Igwilv Raistlin Mahire Mordenkainen Lord Soth Strahd von Zarevich. Celestials Constructs Deathless Draconic Creatures Dragons Chromatic Dragon Metallic Dragon Elementals Fae Fiends Giants Humanoids Lycanthropes Monstrous Humanoids Oozes Outsiders Plants Undead. Notable Beholder Drow Dark Elf Githyanki Illithid Mind Flayer Lich Lists by Edition Original Classic AD.